10 years that Kutless has been around, it's been sort of a crazy journey for my life, really. I was 18 when we got signed. I had just graduated high school in June, and we got signed in October of that summer, so it was 2001. And what happened was I was working at this store in the mall here in Portland. This guy walks in, and I'm starting to help him. We're walking around. He notices that day I was wearing a What Would Jesus Do bracelet, and he goes, "Cool bracelet, are you a Christian?" And I go, "Yeah, man, I am." And so he's like, "Me too." So we started talking about that. I also just moved up here recently from my hometown, Albany, where I graduated high school, and you know, I joined a band with some friends, and we all lived together, and we practiced together, and he's like, "Oh, really? What kind of music do you play?" I was like, "Well, we're kind of like a hard rock band, and you know, it's all about Jesus, and that's what our music reflects." And he goes, "Awesome. Well, my brother owns Tooth and Nail Records." You know, by the following Monday morning, Tooth and Nail was gathered in their office listening to our demo we had made that weekend with Aaron Sprinkle, who was a brand new producer at the time. And Monday morning, they called us in the middle of a staff meeting. We're like, "We love you guys. We want to sign you." And man, the rest is history. We made our first record, went on tour, and we've been touring like crazy ever since.
It's amazing. I can't believe 10 years have gone by already. It's flown by. A lot has changed in our lives. You know, when we first signed our record deal, I just got engaged. I got married in January right after that. And so my wife and I are just getting ready to celebrate our 10-year wedding anniversary as well, which is pretty awesome. And it's been just really neat to see the way that as we travel around the world, I've been totally humbled to see, you know, here we fly clear across the Pacific Ocean to the Philippines, and all these Filipino people are singing our songs as we're playing our music. And I'm just absolutely blown away that our music has reached, you know, across language barriers, across cultural barriers. And the same thing, you know, the first time we went to Europe, flew into Germany, and here all these guys are that, you know, they barely speak English sometimes, and yet they know every word to some of these songs. And I have to say, I just feel super blessed to be a part of this band.
I've been with them for 7 years this next January, so just a couple more months will be my 7-year band-iversary. The thing I like about it is that we've maintained the exact same goals the whole time, and if anything, we've narrowed them down and we've gotten more specific. So it's been cool to be a part of that and just to see not only that we've had goals, but that they've been effective. And you know, it's such a blessing to be able to do anything in your life where you see results, and we've definitely been blessed to see results.